Hello, friends. My name's Cody, and I look after developer relations here at LaunchDarkly. One of the first places we look at when we're implementing feature flags is if the application is a front-end application or a back-end application. We oftentimes think of the front-end use cases first because they're more visual in nature. It's the front door to your app, and it's the first thing people see. So a lot of times those feature flags might be the changing of a button positioning, the adding or removing of a button, changing the theme of the website, enabling developer mode so there's more debug logs. These are all things that we would oftentimes target off of using something we refer to as the user context. The user context is a set of properties that we can target changes off of with our rules engine. So we could say users who fit the dev context receive dev changes. That context might include things like first and last name, the team you work on, what office you work out of, what your time zone is, your email address. And all of these might change the way the application responds to you as a user coming in. But LaunchDarkly focuses on more than just those front-end use cases by enabling back-end feature flags as well. There's a ton of different back-end use cases that are especially useful. A lot of times you might be working with an API, and you might want to roll out API version 2 to your development team. So with the user's team as part of the user context, you can target that user with that API change. In the case of more infrastructure-centric use cases, you might extend that user context to also include the server architecture that's being used. So you might target a change only at your ARM-based system so you can test out a new set of servers that'll potentially save you more money. Backend feature flag uses range from things like migration and being able to control what database is being consumed, the previous example of what API version is being used. You can use these feature flags to turn on or off the API for a maintenance mode and make it only available to your development team. You can ensure that the right users are receiving the right version of your backend systems at any given time, which can also be related back to the way they're consuming it from the front end. We'd love to talk to you more about different front end and back end use cases for feature flags. Check us out on launchdarkly.com or reach out to us anytime. Love to hear from you. Take care.